my life.
Inu aye mi, I will be done.
Ife ti re ni ki a se.
Is anybody like that here?
Yari eni be ni.
Let me hear you say it loud and clear.
Ipoku so lo guru.
That every one of you, from now on, you will begin to excel.
Amen.
Who is the one fellow that you will stand beside him or her and say, you are the one who will get my attention?
Redemption Way.
The Lord is going to surprise someone here tonight.
Join Pastor E.A. Adeboye and other men of God every first Friday of the month as they lead multitudes of worshippers to the presence of God in the monthly Holy Ghost service at the Redemption Camp, Kilometer 46, Lagos Ibadan Expressway, from 6:30 p.m. to dawn. You're watching Redemption Way.
Forever, 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 forever
glory, give him honor. Give him adoration. Bless his holy name. Bless the King of Kings. The Lord of Lords. The Ancient of Days. The unchangeable Lord. Bless his holy name. Oh, you are worthy to be praised. Worthy, you are worthy. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, we give you glory. We give you honor. We give you adoration. Glory, glory, glory be to your holy name, Lord.
Ogo, 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 porukanware, Oluwa.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have given thanks. 2 Kings chapter 4. I'm reading from verse 18 to 26. And when the child was grown, it fell on a day that he went out to his father to the reapers. And he said unto his father, my head, my head. And he said to a lad, carry him to his mother. And when he had taken him and brought him to his mother, he sat on her knees till noon and then died.
And
she went up and laid him on the bed of the man of God and shut the door upon him and went out. And she called unto her husband and said, send me, I pray thee, one of the young men and one of the ashes, that I may run to the man of God and come again.
And
he said, wherefore will thou go to him today? It is neither new moon nor Sabbath. And she said, it shall be well. Then she saddled an ass and said to her servant, drive and go forward. Slack not thy riding for me, except I bid thee. So she went and came unto the man of God to Mount Carmel. And it came to pass, when the man of God saw her afar off, that he said to Gehazi, his servant, behold, yonder is that Shunammite. Run now, I pray thee, to meet her and say unto her, is it well with thee? Is it well with thy husband? Is it well with the child? And she answered, it is well.
Emi bio sureni sisi ki o pade re ki o si wi fun pe alaafia ko lo wa bi alaafia ko ni oko re wa bi alaafia ko ni omode wa bi o si dawo wi pe alaafia ni.
By the time the sun rises tomorrow, there is somebody here who will move from all will be well to it is well. You know the story of this woman very well.
She loved the Lord.
Onife Oluwa.
She was a giver.
Oje olufifunni.
One day she saw the man of God passing by.
Ni ojo kan ri eniyan Olorun ton re koja.
Says, sir, you must come and eat in my house.
Oni alagba, eya ke wa je onile mi.
The man of God said, thank you, I'm not hungry.
Eniyan Olorun so pe e se ebi o pa mi.
The Lord is my shepherd.
Oluwa ni olusu agutan mi.
I don't lack anything.
Emi ko sai ni ohunkohun.
He said, I know.
Oni mama.
But you are not going anywhere.
Ko si bi en lo o.
Unless you come to my house to eat.
Laiye pe eya sile mi lati je.
Very stubborn woman.
Obinrin olori kokun si rere.
Very stubbornly good.
O je olori kokun si rere.
So the man of God went to her house to eat.
Orina ni Olorun ya sile re lati lo jeun.
Enjoy the food.
O gbadun on jije na.
So each time he was passing by, he would not invite himself.
Ah, nigbati eniyan Olorun ba nre koja yo wa pera re wole.
And by the time he had been coming two or three times.
Nigba to fi di ekeji eketa to tin ya wole lati jemu.
The woman decided to increase her giving.
Obirin na pinu ati mu ififunni re di pupo.
Got permission from her husband.
O gba yonda ati ase lodo oko re.
Built a house for the man of God.
E je ko ile fun eniyan Olorun.
Furnished it.
O si ko gbogbo eso sinu re.
So that the man of God now will not be eating an occasional lunch. He can come and take breakfast, lunch, dinner, spend the night.
Eniyan Olorun ki se pe onje osan ni yo ma wa fida kon ko je. Bo ba wu awa ajeta aro otosan tale a si sun nibe bojumo ojo keji.
One day,
ni ojo kan,
God said to the man of God that he was lying on the bed that this woman made.
Ah, Olorun so fun eniyan Olorun to sun sori ibusun.
You've been eating this woman's food.
O tin je ohun je obirin yi.
Sleeping on her bed.
O sun si ori akete ibusun re.
In the house she built.
Ni ile to ko.
You didn't even ask her if she had any need at all.
O ti e fi gba kan bi le re. Boyo ni aini kan.
A man of God said, with everything here.
Eni Olorun so pe pelu gbogbo to wa nibi yi.
This woman needs nothing.
Obirin yo ni lo ko wu.
In any case, woman, what do you need?
But you go ri obirin ki lo to nfe ki lo shine.
You want a contract?
O fe ise agba se bi?
With the king?
Pelu oba?
Or with the general?
Tabi awon olori ogun?
She said, no, I don't need anything.
O lo ti o wo ni lo nko wu.
The man of God said, oh God, didn't I tell you?
Eyan lo so pe Oluwa mi wa so fun abi?
She doesn't need anything.
O ni lo wu ko won.
The Lord asked.
Oluwa wa beere.
Finally, they discovered that the woman was barren.
Lakotan won shawari pe obirin na yagan.
Ah, the man of God, wonderful.
Ole, eyan lo so pe iyanu re.
You have money.
Olowo.
But you can't buy a child.
Be lo romora.
I don't have money.
Emi olowo.
But I have contact with God.
Mo ni isopo mo pelu Olorun.
And somebody here tonight.
And can be anybody ni ale yi.
That which you need.
Eyi ni ti o nfe.
That money cannot buy.
Eyi ti owo o le ra.
Receive it tonight in Jesus' name. So the man of God said.
Tori na eyan Olorun wi pe.
Good.
O da be.
You've done what you can do for me.
What is your to le share for me?
Now I will do what I can do for you.
You know what she will share for?
9 months from now.
Oh, she mess on. See, I go for you.
You have a baby boy.
Wa bi omo konrin kan.
The woman said.
Obirin na dahun.
Sir.
Alagba.
If you enjoy my food.
E ba gbadun on jije ti mo se fun yin.
Just say thank you.
E ja ki mi pe mo se mo ku asin.
And keep going.
Ke se mo ba tin lo.
Don't deceive me.
A se tan mi je.
Man of God said, I've already spoken.
Eyan Olorun so pe mo ti wi na.
And it's already done.
Ase orun ti diro wo di sise.
9 months later.
Osu mesan leyin eyi.
The baby came.
Omo na de.
You can imagine the joy of the woman that day.
Ele ma foju inu wo ayo obirin yi ni ojo na.
At long last.
Pe leyin orayin lopin ojo.
My joy is full.
Ayo wokun.
My testimony is complete.
Eri mi ti pipe.
Now I have everything.
Emi wa ni ohun gbogbo.
And then the child began to grow.
Omo na wa bere si ni idagba.
And you can be sure they took all the care they can of this child.
O le da loju pe gbogbo itoju ike gbogbo ton mo ni sise na se fun omo yi.
But then one day,
ya jaka wa yo.
The child said to the mother,
omo na so fun omo re,
I want to go and see my daddy on the field.
O be lo baba mi loko.
You can go.
O le ma lo.
So the boy went.
Omo na si lo.
Suddenly,
lojiji,
I began to say, my head, my head. So the father said, it must be the son. Please take her to the mother. Child came. She cried, my head, my head. Mother sat him on her lap. And at noon, he died. And the woman said, death?
Iwaiku?
You are joking.
Oshileya, Oshaweke Awadalunda.
This is one victim you are going to vomit. I decree to someone here.
To
everything the devil has stolen from you, you will get back this year in Jesus. So she took the child, opened the door of the room of the man of God, and laid it on the bed. Closed the door, and then sent to the husband, in the midst of transportation, one that can move very fast. Because I want to go and see the man of God. And from the answer of the husband, you see that this woman had constantly been visiting the man of God. New moon. Every Sabbath, she would take something to the man of God.
But
so the husband said, it's not new moon, not Sabbath. Why are you going to the man of God today? She said, all will be well. Tell your neighbor, God is talking to me, you know. He's saying to me, Adeboye, all will be well. Then she got to the man of God. Man of God saw her coming. It's a strange visit. Servant, go and ask her. How is your husband? All is well. What about you? All is well. What about your child? That's where some women would have broken down. But she said, all is
well.
How many of you believe that all will be well with you this year? Let me hear you say, all is well. When you can read the rest of the story, you know the story. Finally, all was well. There is someone called the Prince of Peace. That's point number one. And who is this Prince of Peace? If you know his name, let me hear you shout in
it.
The fact that you love God does not mean that there will be no crisis in your life.
If you are
problems are part and parcel of life.
lasibo wahala o je ko se ma ni fun igbe aye wa kan yi ta wa na
both for Christians and non-Christians
yala Christian ni tabi anything is a Christian ni.
If anybody tells you that the moment you become a Christian,
there
will be no more problems, he's lying to you. Because when you become a
Christian,
you have escaped from the cage of Satan. And the elders have a saying, it is right for the slave to escape. It is also right for the owner of the slave to pursue the slave. The difference between you being a
Christian
is that when the storm comes, you already have the Prince of Peace with you. And one word from him will steal the storm. Every storm in your life shall be stilled tonight in Jesus' name. Psalm 34 verse 19.
Ori Davidi erin leni ogbon ese kokodini ogun.
Psalm 34 verse 19.
Ori Davidi erin leni ogbon ese kokodini ogun.
Says,
o wi pe
many are the afflictions of the righteous.
Opolopo ni ipoju olododo.
Many.
Opolopo
are the afflictions of the
ipoju olododo.
But
sugbon
the Lord delivers him from them all. He didn't say the righteous will never have problems. In fact, he said he will have many. He said, but he will be delivered out of them.
Oh.
In John 16 verse 33. John 16 verse 33. Jesus Christ himself said, in this world you will have tribulations, but be of good cheer, I have overcome the world. In Isaiah 43, verse 2, Isaiah 43, verse 2, he said, when you pass through the rivers, it will not overflow you. When you pass through fire, it will not burn you. He said, because I will be with you. When?
Nigba.
Not if.
Is a boya.
When you pass through the fire.
Nigba to ban lainu ina koja.
Everyone that God will use.
Ogbo lugulugu ti Olorun yo lo.
For his glory.
Fun ogo re.
Will pass through fire.
Yo lainu koja.
Because it is the fire that purifies.
Ori ina ni wenu mo.
In Mark chapter 4, verse 35 to 41. Mark 4, verse 35 to 41. Jesus was in the boat, sleeping, when the storm arose. The fact that Jesus is in your boat does not mean there will be no storms. It only means the boat will never sink. When you say all will be well, you are telling the devil, try your worst. It will be well. Let me hear somebody say it will be well with me. Say it loud and clear. Why? Because there is someone called the Prince of Peace.
Kennedy, you're here to come back and pay your mother's life.
And once it's with you, nothing to worry about. Almost all the people that have talked to us for almost a month now, Daddy, we are worried about Nigeria. We are worried about
2011.
The Prince of Peace is with us. He has spoken. He said, all will be. How many of you believe him? Let me hear you shout hallelujah. So point number one. There is a Prince of Peace. Point number two. There is a Restorer. There are thieves, both physical and spiritual. They are part and parcel of life. In John chapter 10, verse 10. John chapter 10, verse 10. Jesus Christ said, Jesus Christ,
the
thief cometh not, but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But, thank God for but, I have come that he may have life, and that we may have it more abundantly. The thief came to this woman and stole the only son she had in her old age. But there is a restorer. And his name is Jesus. He can bring the dead back to life. He can restore everything the enemy has stolen from you. The only thing you must make sure is that you are not the one opening the door to the thief. The devil is a thief. He wants to steal. He wants to kill. He wants to destroy. Don't open the door to him. The only way you can open the door to him is by sinning. The Bible says so. In John chapter 8, verse 44. John 8:44. He said, he who sins is of the devil. So if you are sinning, then you belong to the devil. And the devil is free to come in and grab whatever belongs to him. James chapter 4, verse 7. James 4, 7. Says, if you submit to God, then you can resist the devil, and he will flee from you. You must make up your mind this year. I will not cooperate with the devil. Once that is settled, all will be well. It doesn't matter what the devil may try. All will be well. And then,
why you?
This woman did something very interesting. She laid the child on the bed. The bed that she made for the man of God. She was saying to God, I have made deposits.
Mo ti fi sibe o mo ti gbin.
It is time for withdrawal.
Oju akoko bayi lati wa gba pada.
The child was interest on her investment.
Omo yi ni ere lori ohun idokowo re.
She didn't ask for the child.
Obi ere fomo.
The child came as an interest.
Omo na wa bi ohun ta le pe ni ere.
But now,
this is
she is saying to the Almighty God, time for withdrawal. Point number three. Have you a deposit with God? So that in the time of crisis, you may say, I want to withdraw. You see, because Psalm 20, verse 1 to 3, Psalm 20, verse 1 to 3, says, the Lord will remember your offerings in the day of trouble. And let's not talking about casual offerings. He's talking about those who have solid deposits with God. Take the example, Acts chapter 9. Verse 36 to 42.
Acts 9, verse
36 to 42. A woman called Dorcas died. And everybody said no. Not Dorcas. So they sent for Peter. When Peter came, they began to show Peter. Look at the dress she made for me. She's the one feeding me. She's the one who sent my children to school. She's the one who did this. She's the one who did that. No, no, Dorcas can't go.
Dorcas,
and God said, okay, Dorcas, go back. Go and continue the good work you're doing. If you die today, how many people will miss you?
And Meloni yok pada nu re tozo pa wo riyama.
It's a simple way of finding out.
Ona torewa torono lati wari ombe.
Travel for 1 month.
Shari ni ajo foshuka.
When you come back, see how many people who say, where have you been?
Awari iya melo ni o bi ope bo ti gba lo bo wo lo ta ri e to si dagbere.
If you go and you return,
to ba lo to pada,
and people just say, good morning, good morning,
ah ha ki o ka ro ka ro na ti ki o ka bo,
you need to check. Because it means that nobody miss you. It means if you die, nobody is going to notice. It's an interesting story in the Bible. Acts 27. Verse 13 to 24. Thank you, Jesus.
Ese o Jesu.
The Almighty God is healing. It's just I don't want to stop telling you. There's a particular one. He said there's somebody here. The pain around your waist. It's as if you are wearing a belt of fire. Almighty asked me to tell you that's okay. Now that's
gone.
He also said there's someone here. Your stomach disorder has become a concern to you.
Inu rirun re gbogbo igba to ba ti de o kan ku o fun ni ohun to n ro pa re.
He asked me to tell you.
O ni so mo.
He has taken care of that also.
O ti se kapa ile na bakan na.
He said there's someone here too.
O ni eni kan be ni bi bakan na.
There's a very terrible liquid flowing from your inner ear.
Ati nu eti re bi oyun kan to buru o nsan jade nbe.
Ask me to tell you to check. It has already dried up.
Amen.
Oh, thank you, Father.
I say, Baba.
Well, let me say amen to this one.
I say, I say, like it, we.
But let's say there's someone here tonight. He said there will no longer be any limit to your promotion.
Amen.
I think God must be talking to me too. I want to say amen to this one. He said there's someone here tonight. Long before this year is over, your joy will overflow. Now, I was saying that there is a story in Acts 27. Verse 13 to 24. Paul was in a boat. And there was a terrible storm. The storm was on for more than 2 weeks. They couldn't even see the sun for about 2 weeks. And Paul was there.
Paul
was
there.
An apostle. You would think an apostle would never experience that kind of storm. And God will say the people felt that, well, the end has come.
Then
an angel visited him.
Angel,
he said, Paul, don't worry, you'll be okay. And because of you, everybody in the ship will be saved. God was saying to Paul, because of your credit with
me,
I will spare the life of all the people around you. Can God look at you and say, because of you, I will spare your family? I feel that kind of credit with God. Remember some years ago, I have a friend who have been supportive in my ministry. And I was praying. And suddenly God said, son, your friend is about to die in
London.
Unless you go to him now, he will die within a week. Thank you, Lord. Quickly, I got a ticket. Flew to London. When I saw my friend, couldn't even believe. But I prayed, like God asked me to pray. And that's more than 14 years now. My friend is still alive. Why would God bother to tell me that somebody is about to die in
London?
Because he had a credit with God. You better make up your mind, brethren. that to stop being a bench warmer in the house of God. This year should be the beginning of a new commitment to the service of God. So that if any crisis should come, you will have a credit to withdraw from. You can't just go to a bank and say you want to withdraw money when you have never deposited there. I can give you other stories. I should go on, but I believe the Lord wants me to impress this on somebody. I have another friend who had also been very, very supportive. He heard in his own ears in 1995, go and put your house in order, because you are about to die. He had it himself. And then he told me. And I laughed. Why did I laugh? Because I know I can talk to my daddy. And I said to my daddy, that man, I still need him here. He's very useful. I need him here. He's listening to me now. He's sitting on the altar. He's been around now for 16 years extra. As many of you as are determined, saying from now on, I will serve this God with all my heart. Every appointment with death, I cancel it in Jesus' name. Point number four. Watch your mouth. What is it that this woman said? All will be well. She graduated from it to all is. She did not say, oh, my head. Look at what the devil has done. No. Proverbs 18:21. He said, death and life are in the power of the tongue. Proverbs 6:2. He said, your mouth can become a snare unto you. Numbers 14:28. God said, Moses, tell the children of Israel, as they have spoken in my ears, that's what I will do to them. Those people said, no, they said they couldn't make it to the promised land. They said, all right, you said so, so shall it be. And then he said, In Mark 11.
In Mark, Origakola.
Verse 23 to 24. Mark 11:23 to 24.
He said,
"If you believe, and you doubt not, you will say,
oh, we
to the mountain, be thou removed, be thou cast into the sea, and it shall be so." He said, "Whatever you say." When you pray, believe that you receive, and you shall have it. What you say is what you will have. Say it loud and clear, it shall be well with
me.
Say it one more time. Say it with confidence. Told you the story of those early days.
When things
were hard. And my wife and I would be struggling over mama raincoat.
About mama. Yala wota, mama dumara lawa lori a wonje.
This one is too thick. You can't eat that alone. Let's cut it into two.
Eni ne obirin ni oja agbanije pon mojo yi ya ge meji fin fun die.
And I would tell her.
Awa so bu pe.
She say are listening to me.
O wa bi ton teti o.
Things won't continue like this. Tomorrow is going to be all right. Thank God today is all right. Tomorrow is going to be better. Say it loud and clear to everybody around you. My tomorrow will be all right.
Please join us on this same station at this time next week for another wonderful experience as Pastor E.A. Adeboye exposes the deep mysteries in the Word of God.